Hey, what's up, guys? L3 here. I'm actually playing something a little bit different today. It's called Homefront. It just came out today, which is March 15th. And I gotta say, it's a pretty interesting game. As you can see here, there's a lot you can unlock. Well, as far as unlockables, I guess there's not tons from what I noticed, but the way you can customize your weapon and customize your classes are very, very, very awesome. And it's definitely a different approach to the FPS series. It's a typical FPS like you would expect, vehicles, explosions, things like that. But certain abilities, like Flak Jacket, for example, is it gives you extra armor. But how you use it is you have to press up on the D-pad, which basically takes away BP points from you, which is called battle points. And so you gain battle points by playing the objective, doing things like that. So in real time, you're purchasing your upgrades. They're not just automatically all there. So it makes for a pretty interesting game, and that's how you purchase vehicles and stuff too. So, if you're saying, "Oh my God, these graphics, look at them, they're so yucky. Oh my God, PS2," just shut up, really, just shut up, because if you're gonna judge a game by graphics, dang, you're stupid, you stupid internet. I mean, it's an awesome game. I'm having tons and tons of fun with it. I've been looking forward to it for a while. Excuse my little speech problem there, and yeah, so I'm happy to get it. And this is typical ground control. The modes don't seem very different, but the way they're played is very, very cool. Because as the match goes on, it gets more intense. And really, there's no. From what I noticed, it's very, very impossible for one team to get so far ahead of the other. It's for the most part, it seems like a pretty balanced type game. But, we'll see. It's just the first day it came out. And I think it's 16 on 16, so it's 32 people right here. And if you don't know typical ground war-ish type games, maybe. They try domination on Call of Duty would be something that kind of reminds you of this, or on Battlefield Conquest. That's the main thing I'm thinking of. So you just hold the points. You get the person who holds the points the longest wins, basically. So that's how it goes. And that guy was super ninja fast mode. He literally killed me. Not only did he kill me, he ran on the back of my other teammate. Literally piggybacked him. I don't know if you saw that, but that may call for a little bit of a rerun there. And I'm not the best at this game. This is one of my earlier matches. But I'm still trying to get used to it, trying to get used to the guns, my abilities, things like that. And overall, I like to be a team player. I don't like to camp with a sniper. There's one map in particular where person or everyone was using a sniper. It's just mountains everywhere. There's huge mountains that you spawn on top of, and the bases you capture are just like in a little valley. So it doesn't really make much sense, because if you use an assault, you're gonna get screwed. I mean, that's just that's one of the problems with that map, but. And I shot an extra RPG just for good measure, because you never know. You never know if someone's in there still or not. But the sniper on this game, you'll see later on in the match I use it is deadly accurate. There's no recoil, and it's spot on. It's a lot of fun. Most people, I think, prefer that, maybe. I'm not totally sure. Some people could complain and say, "Oh, well, it's not realistic. I don't really enjoy it." But honestly, it's a video game. You're here to have fun. I realize there's no drop shot or anything like that, but it's still a fun game, and I definitely enjoy it. It takes one sniper fire to the head, and then about two to overall to kill him. From what I noticed, now I hit him in the upper chest a couple times, and it seems like I killed him, but could have been a headshot. I'm not totally sure. But for me, I just prefer the assault class. That's what I prefer. Automatic burst weapon, just things like that. The SMG doesn't seem to do enough damage, even up close, and even more the heavier weapons don't seem to do too much. Maybe more so on vehicles, because it has C4 and things like that. And dang, he sniped the crap out of me. That is major props to him, because that was a great shot. But yeah, like I said, just assault's the best for me. I notice up close it's the best, and far away it's not too bad either. Obviously, you want to go for sniper for far away. And here, this is actually a really cool part, because I'm going all renegade, I'm going lone wolf. Actually sneak to their base and take C, I believe, all by myself. If this is the round, if not, well, darn. But yeah, I definitely like every class. And what you saw there was an EMP grenade. You can choose between an EMP or a flash grenade. And EMP stuns vehicles, and flash, well, it flashes people. So yeah, they just take their top off, and like that, they flash you. But yeah, the sniper class is fun. Not something I play a lot. I'm not deadly accurate with it, as you can tell. I for some reason I go for the nuts. I don't know why. I just shoot them right in the nuts. But hey, whatever works, And definitely with vehicles and stuff, when you're a sniper, from what I notice, I stay far away, because I don't really know much of the sniper classes or the abilities that come with the sniper. Because if you look in the bottom right-hand corner, you can see my BP points. You can see up on the D-pad is something. Maybe it's like a mini tank. In the bottom, I have like a javelin-type missile. But I don't want to waste money buying those right now because I don't think it'd be the most tactical thing to do. Especially since I'm better with my assault class. And I like to use that. I like to put my body armor on. And there's also a UAV type thing you can have that spends money. But for the most part, I like picking assault, and then I like buying a vehicle and then just playing heavy support with it when it starts getting to the end of the round. And now I know this guy's behind me because when they shoot on the radar, you can see him. So I'm gonna hide right here. But I really didn't want to get too campy, so I was gonna pop out and risk it. And sure enough, there he is. Managed to kill him, which surprised me because I was getting mid-body shots there, but, you know, hey, it worked. And so I pretty much sneaked into the base here. My teammates are helping me out, and it's just pretty much ripping it up here. And as you can tell, there's an X on C there, and I don't think a lot of people realize that yet, but when there's an X on C, that means the area is contested. That means there's someone close enough in the area that they're fighting for the same area too. So if you're in there and you're taking a base and you see an X, that means someone's around there with you, and you got to kill them before you can take it. That's being contested. So that's just kind of basic knowledge, just in case you didn't understand it, because some people don't really understand it. And as they're calling in an airstrike here, you can see on the map in the bottom left-hand corner, there's kind of like a hit marker type thing on the map, and you know, it was centered towards me, so I decided to sit back a little bit. And the red triangles, those are basically, think of it like this. Yeah, I should have stabbed him, but oh well. The red triangles are kind of like, I guess it's someone that called in a UAV maybe, and you can see them. So yeah, but here we go. I spent most of my points. I saved up my points this match, and I'm going this more faster light tank vehicle. And usually I do pretty good in it, but this one, they pretty much destroy me. So, but I managed to get another teammate in here, and we start owning it up pretty good bit. And you know, the animations are a little bit choppy in this game, and you know, it's a little bit outdated, as you can tell with graphics, but it's still a whole lot of fun. And if you're on the fence about it, give it a rent at least, because it's definitely worth it. Especially if you like Battlefield-ish games, because I know I prefer Battlefield over Call of Duty. You know, Call of Duty is great and everything. I'm not trying to compare this game to any of those games. I'm just saying my preference. I prefer larger scale warfare, stuff where you feel like you contribute more, I guess. But yeah, that's just what I prefer. That guy he tries to get away. I mean, it's ridiculous. And you got to hit him spot on at this vehicle, by the way. Unless you're in the there's another teammate in here that's controlling the rockets. And that guy does not want to die. I'm not entirely sure what's going on with him. But anyway, he pretty much owns space. I mean, the tank was about to explode. I got out of it, and he didn't take no for an answer. He really didn't. It was pretty intense there. And so in the bottom left hand corner, you can kind of tell that the green bar is us, because we're playing as USA, and the red bar is KPR, which I'm guessing is Korea, maybe. I'm not totally sure. I know the storyline in this game, it's something about Korea taking over the US. It looks very, very interesting. I can't wait to start playing the single player a little bit. But yeah, those are the two factions, and the green bar is up right now because we're winning. We've held points longer, and we're overall just doing a better job. And you can tell our little red, or our little green, excuse me, square is lit up. And the reason this is because it's really separated into two rounds. That way, say the other team is just dominating you big time. Well, when the round's over, the spawns restart, and you gotta get to them again. That kind of gives you like a second chance. So it can make for really intense matches. It makes it really balanced, makes it really interesting. Like I said, I'm enjoying it a lot. There doesn't seem to be too many overpowered things right now. That there's a UAV type thing in the sky that shoots missiles. That seems pretty insane, but you gotta save a pretty good bit of points for that. And then who knows, there may be a couple things where you can just lock on. I'm not totally sure. Like I said, I'm still getting used to the game. Yeah, but it's a lot of fun. Yeah, that was a good kind of double there, you know. I thought I was about to die, but went prone, and yeah. And you can't dive or anything when you go prone. When you go prone, that's it. You stop on that spot, and it's not like a sudden movement. So, I guess it's kind of more tactical to an extent to go prone. But really, I haven't seen a whole lot of people camping, which it's making it a lot of fun right now. So I hope later on there's just not a whole bunch of people camping, but you never know. You never know this game. So 13 kills, 7 deaths. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. I will be live streaming Homefront on JustinTV.com, JustinTV/Legendary92. So yeah, follow me on there. And thanks for watching.